No time to wait, we just jump right in. The focus of this video is to say, I am and time isn't. This is a super shortcut and a condensed way of stabilizing yourself. You see, destabilization is coming in the world. There's going to be tremendous destabilization. Some of you are feeling it already. It's like a barometer picks up a pressure change, like you feel high, low pressure coming in, and you know a storm is coming. And maybe the storm doesn't get there for a day or two, but you know it's on its way. So some of us are like barometers in the world, and we know something is coming, destabilization is coming. So how do we stabilize? Certainly not by thinking, and fear-based thought is not going to stabilize us. What we need to do is just a clear-cut affirmation. That's it. I am, and time isn't. It could be better than that. I am, and time isn't. That is absolutely a statement of fact, which is what the spiritual path is all about, is the ability to state facts. Not to speculate. State facts. That isn't used enough in this world at all. That type of spiritual approach is the approach that's needed. I am, and time isn't. All right, what is the, is there anything before I am, before being, before reality? No, there's no precursor. There's no time prior to I am. And is it concurrent? Is time something that parallels and goes along with I am as some alternative reality? No, it is not. It is not. I am is a fact. It is true. And time isn't anything. There is no gap. There is no incompleteness in I am. There's no gap where time is filling in. There's no precursor prior to I am. Here's this time-based process leading up to I am. No such thing. We're imagining it. We're absolutely inventing it, make-believing it, pretending. It's all a pretense. It's all a hypothetical scenario. I am and time isn't. So, when you feel the destabilization coming, switch over to that immediately. Don't analyze the situation. Don't try to say, okay, what's going on? What do I need to do? How do I understand this? Let me think about what the right response. Forget about right responses. Just say, I am and time isn't. 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 So it may take a little to get going on this. I know it's different than what most people are used to. Most people are used to ruminating in their mind about, okay, this person did this, and now I feel this is coming here. Now, what if I did this? And that's all part of being trapped in destabilization. Don't be trapped in destabilization. Ascend to stability, fifth dimension, death-free realm, enlightenment. Ascend to that by saying, I am, and time isn't. I am, and time isn't. Okay, I am not in competition with time. I don't have any problems whatsoever because I am and time isn't. That's a fact. Time isn't. Don't say, it's a tendency to say, I'm beyond time or I'm greater than time. No. Say, I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. That is a fact. The rest of the stuff has way too much wiggle room for the mind to start thinking, okay, I'm beyond time, so there's time, and then I'm greater than time. So what was I in time, and I'm greater than time? That's all the game of time. Stop playing the game of time. Say, I am, and time isn't. I am, and time isn't. Where do I get these affirmations? They just come to me because I'm willing to share them. That is why. If you're willing to share truth, then truth will present itself to you. So it just occurred to me this morning, just I am and time isn't. I said, yeah, that sounds good to me. That sounds just right. I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. So destabilization is on its way. But I am and time isn't. Don't try to absorb the instability with your body. Your emotions. Don't try to absorb it at all. Just from a spiritual standpoint, state the facts that I am and time isn't, period. That's all there is to say. Nothing more to say than that. I am and time isn't. You don't have to go into any more depth than that. See, facts don't have depth. They're true right now, and that's it. There's no playing out of the fact. It's just a fact right now. You don't need to say, well, there's some depth to that. Like, well, how deep does that go? No, it's I am and time isn't. So what depth do you need? You don't need to say, well, time isn't this or this or this or this. No, time isn't, period. Never has been, never will be. Time isn't. I am and time isn't. So we are getting up to speed on all this prior to the destabilization. Of course, the world's being destabilized to an extraordinary extent right now, and has been for quite some time, actually. Quite some time. The flood, the waters up the river, the rain is raining really, really hard up river, and we're down river. We got a little homestead and some land on the left near the levee of the mighty Mississippi, for instance, and we think, huh, it's raining pretty heavy up there, up north, upriver. But at least it's not raining here. And you think, well, okay, it's not raining here. And then it keeps raining, keeps raining, keeps raining. The river starts rising a little bit. You start worrying, saying, wow, it's really raining upstream. That's not good. And at some point you say, holy cow, you know, even though it's not raining here and the river hasn't risen that much, it's pouring so heavy upriver. I know the runoff is going to come. And eventually all that water upstream, upriver, is going to make its way to where I am at. And then there's going to be a flood. You see, a destabilization. So just because we haven't experienced in our personal lives a destabilization, etc., doesn't mean it's not coming on a grand scale, because it has been raining, it has been pouring. The destabilization effort has been absolutely pouring down on this planet to an extraordinary extent. And all that runoff is eventually going to make its way downriver. And that's when the river overflows the levees, and then you experience the destabilization. So don't just wait and say, well, I'll see what happens, I don't know. Say, no way, it's raining, I know it's raining so heavily, I'm not going to wait. So the ones that don't wait are the intelligent ones. They just put two and two together and say, the water's going to make its way here for sure. So say, I am and time isn't. What can time say to that? What can anyone say to that? That ends it right there. I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. That's a fifth dimensional statement, fifth dimensional awareness, or enlightened awareness saying, I am and time isn't. Brings time to an end, doesn't it? It brings it to an end. You're not arguing with time. Don't argue with time. That's what sinks the boat. Don't argue with time at all. Doesn't matter what time says. It makes absolutely no difference what time says. My spirit is not in competition with time in the slightest bit, because I am and time isn't. How can I be in competition with time? I am and time isn't. So, there is the key to stability. We're working into this pattern of stability now. My spirit is not in competition with time. I don't have any problems. I've never had any problems. I am problem free. I don't have any needs. I don't need any help whatsoever, because I am and time isn't. Do I need help with something that isn't? No, I don't need any help. I simply need to state the fact and say that I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. It's not an intellectual statement. It's a spiritual statement. You don't have to feel it anywhere in particular. But it's more like a diffuse feeling of just, I am and time isn't. If your mind's whirling around, say, okay, what does that mean? What does that mean? No, that's not it. That is not it. When the mind does that, just again state, just know I am and time isn't. Because that whirling around the mind, that's time. That's time saying, oh, what do you mean by that? Can you explain that to me? What do you mean? If I am and time isn't, what do I need to explain to? There's nothing to explain to. There's nothing to explain to. Time isn't. There's no gap between cause and effect. There's no gap between the creator and the creation. There's no place for time to arise whatsoever. We're just entertaining a hypothetical scenario saying, well, what if there was time? But there isn't. So don't play out this what if there was time scenario. State the truth of the situation, that is, I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. My spirit is not in competition with time. I don't need any help. I don't have any needs. I don't have any problems. I've never had any problems because I am and time isn't. I've never had any problems because I am and time isn't. Okay. So this literally is how one moves into the stability that we need at this time. The world will not move you into the stability. You have to move yourself into it from a spiritual declaration. Make spiritual declarations. Some call them affirmations, mantras, whatever. Spiritual declarations is how you are truly centered in truth. That's how you get centered in truth. Say, I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. Now eventually the sense of just I am will come, but in this world where we're saturated with the hypothetical notion of time, it seems to be helpful to say I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. And time will say, okay, well, how do I get this I am? I understand what you're saying, but where's this I am? No, I am and time isn't. There is no what if, how, you know, how do I get this? There is no getting, how do I get it? I am, and time isn't. That's a fact. And we are just, if we don't accept this fact, then of course we're going to be confused. And confusion rests upon a very unstable foundation, and that unstable foundation can be easily rocked. And then you have destabilization. So this scenario of the world is a very unstable place. Don't build your house upon sand or straw. Build it upon a rock. And that rock is, I am and time isn't. All right, I am and time isn't. Don't explain it. Don't get into any explanation with time, as it were. When you're saying this, it's simply, I am and time isn't. What is there to explain? It's a declaration. It's making a declaration. That's different. That's different. So we're now moving into the phase of declarations, where we have a lot of context built up, explaining, kind of loosening everything up. It's necessary to untangle a lot of fear, so we're not so afraid of declarations. And then we get to a point where we say, ah, it's no problem. I am and time isn't. That's simply a declaration. We don't need to say anything else. If you meet a truly awakened being, a great savior, teacher, if you ask them all these questions, you know they're going to answer you with a declaration. That's how they will answer you, actually. Now, of course, that's difficult for us to do. We can do it here in this video. I am, and time isn't. But we're not socially interacting within a social context where there's so much pressure in this world of expectations to kowtow to time. The feeling that time is absolutely essential. So it is profoundly difficult for us to speak merely in declarations, but a great teacher can do that. So you might say, "Whoa, what about this?" And da 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 questions. And they will just tell you, they will be quiet and just say this. Say, "I am and time isn't." Just say that. And you say, "Well, wait a minute, how's that answer my question?" And they say, "Well, look, if you say that, you realize your question isn't necessary, because who are you explaining it to? I am and time isn't. What more do you need to know?" You don't need to explain it to time. Why explain anything to what isn't? And why explain anything to what is? Just declare, I am and time isn't. And that's it. I am and time isn't, and that's it. You might put it in a three-part explanation there. I am, time isn't, and that's it. I am and time isn't, and that's it. And why did this picture freeze up is the question. That is not good. I am, time isn't. I am and time isn't, and that's it. Game, set, match, it's all over. Entirely, it's all over. I am, and time isn't, and that's it. Hopefully this video is recording. I don't know. There's always some technical problem, believe me. But that's okay, because I am and time isn't. You see, technical problems don't change that fact at all, do they? They just make the declaration. Make a declaration every step of your life right now. It needs to be a declaration. That is the key to getting past the destabilization, the instability that's coming. I am and time isn't. My spirit is not in competition with time. My spirit is not in competition with time. And I have no problems. I am and time isn't, and I have no problems. I am and time isn't, and I have no needs. I am and time isn't, and I don't need any help. I am and time isn't, and my spirit is not in competition with time. You see? I am and time isn't, and that's it. So these are declarations that you can use every aspect of your day, no matter what it is. We have a technical glitch here. That's okay. We say I am and time isn't. I don't have any problems. Time has problems. Time is the one having a technical glitch. I'm not having a technical glitch. See? I'm not having any technical glitch at all. It's time that's having the technical glitch. And I am and time isn't. Now we can imagine, well, what if time was, but it still isn't. It still isn't. So I am and time isn't. My spirit's not in competition with time. So people want to know, well, what's the destabilization that's coming up? Okay. Well, the picture's frozen, but it still seems the recording audio. It doesn't matter what the destabilization is, because still I am and time isn't, and that's it. The response is going to be the same. So we might as well start practicing the response right now, instead of saying, well, we'll wait and see what the destabilization is, and then we'll figure out what to say. No, it doesn't matter what happens in time. I am and time isn't, and that's it. But time can become very unstable. Very unstable, as a matter of fact. That's its purpose is instability, which holds an element, of course, of stability. So you have instability and the dance of stability and instability, always stability giving way to instability. Life, these forms we call life, giving way to death, in other words. And that's the purpose of time, is to attempt to delay total instability, which is total mental chaos, by parsing it out a bit at a time, bit at a time, bit at a time, and then sometimes a lot, to see if we can get used to it. It's trying to get us used to total instability. It says maybe if we just get used to all this instability for like eons and eons and eons and eons, that one day we'll be able to abide in total instability, and we'll say, ah, this is just perfect. I love this. That's it. That's what time's trying to do, really. It defends against total mental chaos, but it's also trying to pre-stress us so we gradually get used to instability and chaos. So it doles out chaos and instability constantly. Sometimes it doles it out in the big old dollops, so you just like get hit by it so hard, and then time says, how are you doing with this one? Are you feeling kind of comfortable with all this instability and think you can handle total mental chaos yet? Well, you know, but we say no, I am and time isn't. I don't need any attribute of being able to abide in total instability, total mental chaos, because I know that's just an effect that arises from my crazy whim of wanting to be prime creator, and I no longer want to be prime creator. So I don't need any such capacity, and I don't need to train myself, keep training myself to attain that capacity. Time is a training. Okay, time is a training. It's a what if we could abide in total mental chaos. That's an even clearer way of talking about time. It's what if we could learn to abide in total mental chaos? What if we could teach ourselves that And that's time. That's what we're trying to teach ourselves. Because we think if we could abide in total mental chaos, then we could be prime creator. See, that's the only way we could ever do it. But the fact is, we cannot abide in it, which is something I discovered directly by trying to abide in it, and I found out you cannot. It's impossible. It's impossible, because the total mental chaos, there's no reference point whatsoever, endlessly. And you feel this sense of utter loss, as it were, and it's completely opposite of what you are, what you truly are, and God's will remains what you are is God's will, and therefore you cannot abide in what is a complete negation of God's will. It's not possible. It's not possible. You don't have it in you. It's not possible. You can never learn this. So time is a waste of time. Which one of the viewers commented, time is a waste of time. That is exactly right. Time is a waste of time. It really is. It really is. Time is a waste of time. Big time waste of time. Time is a big time waste of time. It's a total waste of time. I am, and time isn't. How much a waste of time is what isn't? It's a big waste of time, isn't it? It's a total waste of time. It's nothing more than a waste of time. I am, and time isn't. So time is how we're trying to learn, how I try to learn to abide in total mental chaos, which is a futile path. When you finally make the big effort to try to abide in total mental chaos, say, okay, I'm ready. Let's be enlightened, so to speak, from the standpoint of time, you realize it's not possible. It is not possible. And then you say, oh my gosh, what have I spent all this time on? That is crazy. The goal is unreachable. And time in itself is absolutely horrible. The only reason why we put up with time is because we think we can reach the goal. And somehow the goal is going to be absolutely fantastic for us. We can be prime creator. That's it. That's the only reason. So if we find out that the goal is not reachable, then we say, wait a minute, this is terrible. The goal is not reachable. So what am I doing? What do I do with time? This is absolutely horrible. This is absolutely suffering. Guaranteed that people seem to be happy in this world, happy in time, because they're believing, they think they're getting it. They feel they're getting it. It's coming. They're going to get it. And the goal is going to be reached. But when you find out that the goal is unreachable, it totally changes your outlook on the world and time. You become kind of depressed, actually. And you say, whoa, you know, wow, I really better get out of this time then. I better free myself from this, because otherwise I'm just going to be absolutely miserable and depressed forever. So all this happiness in the world is a facade. It's an absolute facade. It is just a pretense of saying, hey, well, I'm getting it. When you realize that you can't get it, then the jig is up, and you become kind of serious, and you don't tend to be so happy and laughing and thinking that life, the existence, time is worthwhile. You see, you realize it's not worthwhile. Then you say, what do I do now? And then you get serious and you get sober and you start paying attention, and eventually you find your way to these basic affirmations, basic spiritual declarations. For instance, A Course in Miracles is just basically a lot of declarations, a fact, really. And it gets us used to making simple declarations a fact. Now, I didn't always like that at all. But at this point, I see that is, it feels very natural right now to make simple declarations of fact. But they come up on their own. Like, for instance, I am and time isn't. This is not something I took out of A Course in Miracles. It just was given to me by the Holy Spirit just today, just to say that. I am and time isn't. It resonates right now. The simplicity resonates. So we're not bound by any curriculum or any dogma. We can, whatever occurs to us that is most helpful, we can use that. We don't have to say, wait a minute, let me go look at the compendium of of A Course in Miracles, and let me search for these terms, I am and time isn't, and let me see if it was said in there someplace, and if we can't find it, we'll spend like a year searching and say, wait a minute, it's not in there, I can't use it or something. That's a ridiculous, that's absurd. We were not made for the curriculum was made for us, and we are primary. And the curriculum is living, it's alive, it's intelligent. So we can say, I am and time isn't. And my spirit is not in competition with time. And I don't have any, my spirit doesn't have any problems. I am and time isn't, my spirit has no problems. No problem. I have no problems, I have no needs, I don't need any help. I am and time isn't. And in spite of this picture freezing up, I know that that's time that's freezing up, and yet I am and time isn't. I'm not freezing up. So at this time in the world, in time, at this time in time, when destabilization is coming, people are desperately searching for how to react to this. I know this is a fact. And they're not looking at simple declarations. They think it's complex. So they're looking for some complex, artful, you know, brilliant chess moves or something like. I mean, this. How do I make these chess moves? And I was caught up in that yesterday myself, thinking. I said, there's this problem that's arisen. And I say, how do I deal with this? It's so complex. And I looked at it and I say, my gosh, it's unsolvable. And literally, I'm behind the eight ball here. Literally, is a fact that this world is behind the eight ball and is in a no-win situation. I realized I was in a no-win situation, which is very frustrating because you think you should be smart enough to find a way to win. So there's no way to win. And that's when it occurred to me to say, I am and time isn't. And that's the only way you can do it is to simply dismiss time. You can't beat time. You cannot beat time. Time will beat you at its own game. It will beat you at its own game. If you play the game of time, time will beat you. It will defeat you. It will defeat anybody. Anyone who plays the game of time, you'll be defeated. However, you don't have to play the game of time. You can say, I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. Looked at this odometer today and it said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Skip the 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. And I said, that's nice. Skip the 6. 7's a better number than 6. We skipped right over it. So, we can skip right over the 666, as it were, by saying, I am and time isn't. If we try to match wits with time, we're going to lose. We are going to lose. And that's what I saw. I said, oh my gosh. No matter how smart we are, if we play the game of time, we're going to find out that we're on the losing side, because we're engaging, we're trying to defeat what isn't. So we're really trying to, you know, that's no matter what you do, you still feel somehow you're losing. So don't try to defeat time. Just simply say I am and time isn't. There's no attempt to defeat time. There is there. Just I am and time isn't. Full stop, I am, and time isn't. That's it. That's all there is to say. And so when time starts poking in, say, hey, what's the matter? Don't you think you can beat me? You say, I am, and time isn't. I don't need any help. I am, and time isn't. My spirit's not in competition with time. How can I be in competition with what isn't? How can what is be in competition with what isn't? I am, and time isn't. So this is the extremely simple form. We can go to this I am and then just silence, but for declarations purpose, let's make this I am and time isn't. 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 And you can add on stuff, you know, make your own song, as it were, make your own declaration. I have no problems. I am and time isn't. I am free because I'm as God created me. I am still as God created me. I am, and time isn't. So let us see if this video actually recorded, which would be great.